So welcome to the next section of our training program, that is the antibiotic stewardship program by CDC guideline. Why this program is important? Again, the Indian government also has launched the red line program. In this program, on antibiotic labels you will find a red line. It means this product should not be sell over the counter product and should be prescribed by the doctor specifically. So that is called as a red line movement. So why this antibiotic stewardship or antibiotic policy is important for dentists? As we deal with many endodontic procedures or even the periodontics procedure and other minor surgical procedures, and as we are dealing with extractions on regular basis, we used to prescribe antibiotics to our patients. But again, we should prescribe these antibiotics according to the level of evidences available for its use. This is to avoid resistance of bacteria against this antibiotic. Why antibiotic stewardship program is important? This is because, as we all know, this coronavirus has evolved very rapidly and killing our lives. There is a chances of superbug attack as well. Now, what is superbug and all, I'm not going in detail of that. But if you see, in the last few years, we have not come up with any new antibiotic, and that is the alarming situation for all of us. WHO have already explained that we are going very rapidly towards the antibiotic resistance, means the existing pathogens or the bacteria, viruses are getting resistance to the multiple antibiotics. And if you are seeing the, if you are having any medically compromised patient in your family, like diabetic patient or any other infectious diseases, you will see that many times doctor used to change antibiotics and prescribe higher and higher antibiotics for those patients. This is because the bacteria are already getting resistance to many antibiotics, and we have to take care of this while prescribing antibiotics for dental purpose or dental treatments. So this is the evidence which is taken for antibiotic prescribing. According to the ADA Council of Scientific Affairs, we should start with the narrow spectrum of antibiotics first and then to the broad spectrum of antibiotics. Again, I request you all that as we are providing the infection control record book for maintenance of infection control program, there we are giving a separate section for antibiotic policy, where you should maintain which antibiotic you have to prescribe for which patient, means during which treatment you should prescribe a particular antibiotic, and you have to go through the evidences available. You can take a help from your friends who are expert in the particular subject, like endodontist, oral surgeon, periodontist, and you can maintain your individual policy for prescribing these antibiotics. And again, one thing that you should maintain while prescribing any medication, you have to keep record of that prescription with you. Means if you are giving a prescription to the patient, you have to maintain the same copy with you. So for this purpose, you can have a printed prescription, or if you are prescribing it on the prescription pad, you can keep a carbon copy of that. This is again important to protect yourself from the legal affairs in future. So according to the ADA Council guideline, you can use clindamycin, metronidazole or penicillin as a narrow spectrum antibiotics. And in broad spectrum, you can start with the amoxicillin with clavulanic acid combination and other medications which is given into the policy. Then again, there is a confusion that for how much duration we should prescribe the antibiotic. So most of us followed the what we have been taught in our dental colleges, that we should prescribe antibiotic for 3 days or 5 days. Of course, most of us followed how we have been taught by our seniors in while doing extraction or while doing endo treatments in our third year and final year and internships. So guys, if you want to prescribe antibiotic, the guidelines are, you have to prescribe then for the duration, you have to prescribe most targeted, that is narrow spectrum antibiotic, for a shortest duration possible, that is a 2 to 3 days after the clinical signs and symptoms get over in otherwise a healthy patient. So if your patient is medically compromised, you can contact the physician of the patients or diabetic expert or diabetologist of the patient to ask that which antibiotic and for how much duration you can prescribe that antibiotic, so that you can evaluate the if that patient is resistant for the particular antibiotic. So this is about the antibiotic stewardship program according to the CDC guideline. So in next section, I'm going to discuss about how to decontaminate or how to disinfect your impressions while before delivering it to the lab, before pouring those impressions. Thank you.